During the pandemic, all industries have had to adjust quite drastically, including public transportation. As we're seeing the re-entry into the world for non-essential workers and folks going back to school in general, we wanted to take this moment to look into how is public transportation having to adapt. If there are hybrid workplaces, we may not still have rush hours back in public transit, so how do you deal with that going forward? The way that the Washington Post approached 3D commute is, how can we bring you into all of these different things that the public transit authorities are trying to figure out at this point? And what do commuters think about all of this? The lab chose three cities to feature in this story: New York City's subway system, the Washington, D.C. metro system, and the San Francisco BART serving the Bay Area. We wanted to choose LiDAR scanning for this visual format because we wanted to be able to construct an actual environment that you can safely board. It's an extension of a camera. It's a depth sensor, so it shoots out light, kind of like how sonar works with sound, to be able to map an environment around you or an object right in front of you. It's really important to have a strong 5G connection because even though getting 3D models is more accessible, it's still a very heavy amount of data. So we leveraged the AT&T 5G hotspot to help support loading up those 3D scans and being able to share and produce with our distributed team across the country. When you're going to do a LiDAR 3D scan, get your smartphone that has a LiDAR or depth sensor in it and your 5G hotspot that helps connect you just in case you lose connection wherever you are. Board the train, take your phone, and basically start moving through the car so you can see that filling in as a full 3D model inside and out. When a reporter steps off the train and is done with their 3D scans, having a strong, fast, and reliable connection helps us be able to power that storytelling in a lot of different ways. We were able to stay connected in the field and be able to direct things from across the country and put together a really beautiful and concise story. We wanted to be able to bring you into that space and be able to board the trains so you can listen to folks who are on that train right now. I would hope that 3D commute and our story going forward can really help people make informed decisions about what it looks like for them to return to public transit. And I think it's a very vital issue right now to shed more light on and be able to hear from actual everyday commuters. I think what 3D storytelling can best do for our readers is really help them understand events that happened or a different space to be able to go through, even sports in the future of not being able to attend the Olympics perhaps. This early experimentation with 5G connectivity helps us tell more stories of access in the future. 15 years ago, every story needed a photograph for you to understand what's going on. This is just the next step in that journey.